for more such videos, like our YouTube channel, and I'm sure that you will have much, much more interactive videos on that, which will be very, very useful in your preparation.
Good morning, friends. My name is Dr. Divya. I am the faculty at DBMCI Ayush. Today we will be discussing a topic from medicine. As you all know, medicine is a subject in the allied which is having maximum weightage in your homeopathic PG exam. So starting with the question, I will be discussing 12 years old Ravi presented with gross hematuria with 80% of dysmorphic RBCs 2 days after attack of upper respiratory tract infection. Diagnosis most likely is, option A is microangiopathic thrombotic anemia, B IgA nephropathy, option C is post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, and option D is Henoch-Schönlein purpura. Before getting to the question, I would like to discuss that there are hematuria following respiratory tract infection. So to differentiate the hematuria after the respiratory tract infection, here I want to explain hematuria following respiratory tract infection. So hematuria following respiratory tract infection can be divided into two types. First is you are having respiratory tract infection and then you developed hematuria. First is the syn-pharyngitis. Hematuria. What do you mean by syn-pharyngitic hematuria? Syn-pharyngitic hematuria develops early after pharyngitis. For example, you are having a upper respiratory tract infection, pharyngitis, and soon after you develop hematuria. The duration is generally less than 1 week. Second type is the delayed hematuria. What do you mean by delayed hematuria? Delayed hematuria होता है जब respiratory tract infection के बाद आपको hematuria more than 1 week. It is delayed. That is, hematuria develops after pharyngitis or any respiratory tract infection after a delay. Generally, we consider this delay more than 1 week, and there is a significant latent phase after upper respiratory tract infection. So again, hematuria following respiratory tract infection can be divided into two. One is syn-pharyngitic hematuria, one is delayed hematuria. First one, there is hematuria after upper respiratory tract infection in 2 to 3 days. In delayed hematuria, there is hematuria after respiratory tract infection, which is delayed with the latent phase in between, which is more than 1 week. Now coming to first type, that is syn-pharyngitic hematuria. If the primary renal manifestation is present, that is hematuria, most likely the diagnosis will be IgA nephropathy, which is also known as Berger's disease. So if the patient is suffering with upper respiratory tract infection and without any delay, soon he develops hematuria as his primary manifestation, then the person is suffering from most likely IgA nephropathy. Coming to the second type, that is delayed hematuria. Delayed hematuria, if the person is suffering from upper respiratory tract infection and there is a delayed time phase, there is a latent phase in between before developing the hematuria, then there can be two conditions. First is your primary manifestation is the renal manifestation. Then the condition can be post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. If your primary manifestation after that delayed phase is the renal manifestation, renal symptoms, then that is post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. But if your primary manifestations are skin symptoms like purpura, rashes, or systemic symptoms like abdominal pain, arthralgia, along with nephritis and hematuria, which develops most commonly after the skin symptoms, then the diagnosis most likely is to be Henoch, Schönlein, purpura. So here we are dealing with three conditions which develop after respiratory tract infection. We developed hematuria. Respiratory tract infection hua, fir patient ko hematuria hoga ya fir kuch gap ke baad hoga, that is the latent period, ya fir turant ho jayega in 2 to 3 days. If it happens soon after upper respiratory tract infection with primary renal manifestation, the most likely diagnosis is your IgA nephropathy. If there is a delayed hematuria with primary manifestation of renal symptoms, then the diagnosis is post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. But if there is delayed hematuria with primary manifestation of purpura rash, systemic symptom like abdominal pain, arthralgia, and then hematuria develops, then the condition is most likely to be Henoch, Schönlein, purpura. So coming to our question, 12 years old Ravi presented with gross hematuria, 80% dysmorphic RBCs 2 days after the attack of upper respiratory tract infection. So we have a delay of 2 days, that is less than 1 week, that is the person is having syn-pharyngitic hematuria. So, the most likely diagnosis is IgA nephropathy. Other important symptom of IgA nephropathy is the gross hematuria. So, now we will be discussing about IgA nephropathy, Henoch, Schönlein, purpura and post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis separately. These are the three conditions: IgA nephropathy, post-streptal glomerulonephritis and Henoch, Schönlein, purpura. Starting with IgA nephropathy, it is the most common cause of nephropathy worldwide. So IgA nephropathy is the most common cause of nephropathy worldwide. Post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis is the most common cause of glomerulonephritis in children. Now coming to the features of all the three. First is increased mucosal IgA synthesis. This is present in IgA nephropathy, that is IgA is increased in IgA nephropathy. It is not seen in post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, but in Henoch, Schönlein, purpura, as we all know, it is an immune complex deposition of IgA. So there will be elevated level of IgA in Henoch, Schönlein, purpura. So in Henoch, Schönlein, purpura as well as IgA nephropathy have increased level of IgA. Coming to the next point is the clinical features. Now, the clinical feature of IgA nephropathy is gross hematuria, plus microscopic hematuria. That is, hematuria can be seen with the naked eye as well as under the microscope. Both are present, and the hematuria that is present in IgA nephropathy is recurrent. That is, recurrence occur very frequently. Second, we have protein urea, which may or may not be present in IgA nephropathy. And third, we have hypertension, which is generally seen in IgA nephropathy. So, we have three features very common in IgA nephropathy. First is gross and microscopic hematuria, which is recurrent. Proteinuria may or may not be present. Hypertension is very common. Coming to clinical features of post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. As we all know, there is delayed hematuria with proteinuria. The patient may have oliguria, cola-colored urine, and because of oliguria, there is retention. So, peripheral edema or orbital edema may be seen. Now, in this case, this hematuria is rare reoccurrence. So, the recurrence in IgA nephropathy is very common. Recurrence in post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis is rare. Why it is rare? Because it gives a lifelong immunity to the patient. Coming to Henoch-Schönlein purpura, clinical feature, first there will be palpable purpura, rashes, systemic symptoms like arthralgia, colicky abdomen pain, and then we have delayed microscopic hematuria, which may lead to proteinuria. So, we have clinical features of Henoch-Schönlein purpura. It is a rule always that palpable purpura, all the skin symptom will be present prior to the hematuria, and there is delayed hematuria in this type of Henoch-Schönlein purpura. Now, recurrence may or may not occur. Recurrence is common in IgA nephropathy. Now, in post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, we have ASO titer positive, which is negative in IgA and negative in Henoch-Schönlein purpura. As there is complement C3 depression, IgA nephropathy and Henoch-Schönlein purpura have normal level of C3. So, differentiating features between all three types of nephropathy we have discussed. IgA nephropathy, the cause of nephropathy, most common cause of nephropathy worldwide. IgA level is increased. It is having a clinical feature of gross hematuria as well as microscopic hematuria, and recurrence is common. Proteinuria may or may not be present. Hypertension is seen. In post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, there is delayed hematuria, proteinuria, oliguria, cola-colored urine, peripheral edema. Occurrence is rare, recurrence is rare. ASO titer is positive and C3 complement level is decreased. Henoch-Schönlein purpura, IgA level is increased. There is palpable purpura and rashes, systemic symptom like colicky abdominal pain, delayed microscopic hematuria, recurrence may occur, and C3 level is normal. Thank you.